In SwiftUI, both Observable Object and Observable are used to manage data and trigger UI updates, but they differ in how they are applied. In this video, you'll see a clear comparison between the two approaches with a focus on which offers more flexibility and ease of use for your SwiftUI projects, leading to a definitive winner. Let's dive in. Observed versus Observable Object. Which one is better? Of course, as you might expect, the newest one, the Observable. But today we are going to dive deep and I'm going to show you an example of how to do that. And while we do that, you are going to learn the basics of data handling in SwiftUI. Now, this is a part of SwiftUI Camp. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for an 80% discount link for the first 5 students. This is part of week 1 where we are going to talk about all of this stuff and much more. MVVM, how views work, all of that stuff. So if you're interested, go ahead and check out the link in the description. So observed versus observable. I have prepared a demo project right over here. It's basically O content view. So for the observed one, and then we have OO content view, observable object content view, and both of them are inside a nice tab view in my content view. So if I build and run, we should see just a simple tab. There we go, observable object view kind of, and observable view. So what we are going to do is create some sort of a counter. And while we are doing this, we are going to get into how to handle data in SwiftUI and why actually observed is much better than observable objects. So let's start off with the old-fashioned way of doing things. So let's go into this OO content view, so the observable object type of data handling, and let's create a view model. So class observable object, yeah, that's fine. And I'm going to rename this to content view model, OO content view model. Okay, and then I'm going to add published var, and not text, but count one. And this will be, yes, an int value, and the default value will be 0. I'm going to duplicate this and have count to right over there. So that's our content view model. We are going to add that into our content view. So let's just have that as state object var view model. There we go. And let's just have equals. Yeah, let's just initialize it. So dot init, that's fine. And now we want to have our count views. So we are going to have a vertical stack right over here. And yeah, we are going to have two views, count one view and count two view. And in the body, I'm going to have an increment button. So let's have a VStack first. So VStack. And inside the VStack, I'm going to have, come on. Yeah, this looks really nice. Let's just have that. I'm going to go from there. So there we go. View model dot count. And of course, we don't have access to the view model. So what we want to do is just have it as an environment object. Environment object var view model, that's fine. And yeah, that should be fine. Let me just do that for count two. So count two, and then count two view model dot count two, and we are going to increment it by two. Okay, so now that we have that, I'm just going to add count one over here, and then count two. Okay, yeah, that should do it. Now we don't have the environment, so we want to set this up as an environment object of a view model. Mastering SwiftUI is a fantastic opportunity as it streamlines the process of creating beautiful, responsive user interfaces for all Atoll platforms with minimal coding effort. Its declarative syntax allows developers to build complex UIs more efficiently, speeding up the development process and making it more enjoyable. Now, you can learn SwiftUI in just 4 weeks with SwiftUI Camp, a hands-on intensive course designed to help you create real-world projects fast. With an 80% discount in the video description, it's the perfect chance to upgrade your skills and elevate your app development. Hopefully, I did not miss anything. Basically, that's it. Let's build the run and then increment 1, 2, and then increment this one, 1, 2. Okay, so we don't really see any changes, but what I want to do is add an extra stuff right over here. So right over here, on the count one, I'm going to write in something like this, let underscore equals, and self with a capital S dot underscore print changes. So what this will do is it's going to print the changes in the view whenever they occur. So basically when we are reloading the views. So let's build and run once more. And you know, when the count is updated, you should expect that, okay, this view will be updated. So let's have that. Let me just move all of this over here, and maybe let's just delete all of the current logs. So let's me just tap on increment. And as you can see, on count one and count two, the view has been changed. So basically, it's refreshing these two views and these two views too. Let's see what happens if I tap on count two. Increment, the same thing happens. So that's kind of the drawback of the observable object and the published variables. So count one was incremented only, but since count two was in the same observable object as count one is, the views that are linked to count two will also be updated. So yeah, it's not that efficient. So let's see how to do all of this with the new version, the observed one. So what I'm going to do is just, basically I'm just going to copy all of this out and paste it into the content view. So right over here, I'm going to do some name changes, of course, because I do need to have those. So let's remove that O. And let's take care of not having duplicate ones. So I'm going to make this file private. Okay, and I believe we should have file private also over there. So file private, we should have file private over here and over here. Okay, so now it should be fine. The invalid redeclaration should go away. Okay, all the warnings went away. If we build and run, we should see basically, it's working, but the view model should be with 1.0. Great. Okay, so now let's move away from the observable object into the observed. So what do we have to do? Well, first of all, you have to be on iOS 17 plus, and then you can just add this macro at observable. Okay, that's fine. And then you can just remove this and also remove the published annotation right over here. Great. Next up, how we declare it. It is a state, and that's correct. And instead of setting up as an environment object, we are setting it up as an environment. Just environment, just like that. We have that. Now, instead of environment object, we are accessing it differently. So we are going to have at environment, and then this is going to be the one. Well, let me just comment this out. By the way, it's just 1.0. O content view model dot self var view model. That's correct. And then we can just have view model count one, view model count one. Okay, same goes over here. So I'm just going to copy it out and paste it in there, and let's comment that one out. Okay, so now it should work with the new observed
count. Okay, so we have this. Let me just delete, because that's coming from that one. And right over here, now you see count one, count two has been added. That's perfectly fine. Now, what happens if I tap on increment on the one? As you can see, only count one has been updated. So only these views have been updated. What happens if I tap on count two? Count two. There we go. Only these have been updated. So much, much needed memory improvement. It's really, really great. Now, also, you might want to find out how to bind this environment or how to use it with MVVM. Well, you can learn all of that with SwiftUI Camp. Link for 80% discount is down in the description. Go ahead and check it out. It's SwiftUI Camp. Only 5 seats available at that discount. By the way, only 10 available in total. Go ahead and check it out. And I will see you in the next one.